الأحزاب. الله the Almighty says إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات. Indeed, the believers, إن المسلمين والمؤمنين والمؤمنات, the believers who submit themselves, the men and the women who submit themselves to Allah the Almighty, the men and the women who believe in Allah, the men and the women who are obedient to Allah, the men and the women who are trustworthy, the men and the women who are patient in whatever they are in truth, the men and the women who prostrate to Allah the Almighty, the men and the women who give charity, sadaqah, the obligatory one and the optional one, the men and the women who are trustworthy, and the men and the women who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with heart, from their deep heart and their tongue. They are remembering Allah with heart and tongue. So that is my point today. To remember Allah the Almighty with heart and tongue. That is what we call dhikrullah. So dhikrullah, to remember Allah, that is what the meaning of dhikrullah is. The meaning of dhikr, if I just give you like a quick definition of dhikr, is that Allah the Almighty gave us this Quran, and one of the names of the Quran is called dhikri. And dhikri, which means to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dhikri means remembering Allah, reminding others, and having that in mind all the time, in wherever you are in. That is remembrance of Allah. It's also the meaning of mentioning Allah, to mention Allah and to talk about Allah. It is also perfecting Allah, to talk about the perfection of Allah, the Almighty of Allah, the highness of Allah, the glory of Allah, the magnificence of Allah, how Allah is so beneficial, the beneficent one, the most merciful one, the magnificent one, the higher one, the best one, and the one that everything and everybody needs, but he needs no one. So that Allah, you should keep mentioning him, about him, throughout your life. Be wherever you are, and in any situation you are, you must keep mentioning Allah the Almighty in all your lifetime as a Muslim. And that is the meaning of being in dhikrullah. So the Quran, that means like almost half of the Quran is talking about the dhikrullah. That is why dhikr is one of the names of the Quran. Quran is Quran, Kitab, and dhikr. That is how it is. So when you divide it into three, at least one portion of the third portion of the one of the third is talking about dhikrullah, how to remember Allah the Almighty. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to us, ordering us to keep mentioning Allah in every situation. Allah says in Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 191, Allah is saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. The other part, ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض, that one needs another discussion. But let me just highlight this, the first part of this ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. Those who remember Allah, those the ones who are successful in their life, in this world and hereafter, those who يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا. Those who mention Allah in while they are standing, when they are sitting, وعلى جنوبهم, and when they are lying on their own side. If you are sleeping on your bed, you keep mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as you are not unconscious, you must keep talking about Allah and mentioning Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that. Why? That's why the meaning of worshiping Allah is that one. It's not only when you are performing the regular five prayers. It is that throughout your life, wherever you are, in any situation, keep mentioning Allah, dhikrullah. And that's the meaning of dhikrullah. I also want to clarify one thing. What is dhikrullah? Dhikrullah, maybe some of us will think that dhikrullah is to recite some poems that which were written by some former scholars, or to make chants and to make singing. That is not dhikrullah. Dhikrullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, and for in the Quran and in the hadiths, it has been mentioned many times. And very simply, it is that, as what is written here for us, astaghfirullah, and this subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, those are enough. You keep repeating that, subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, alhamdulillah. You keep saying that, those are enough. If you say 1,000 times, it's okay, well, as much as you can. Keep saying that. That is the meaning of dhikrullah. And you can do that in any situation. Only when you are in the toilet, maybe you should not say that. But whenever you are anywhere, you keep saying it. That is one of the meaning of dhikrullah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering us how it is. Then Allah is telling us that we keep mentioning dhikrullah in our prayer. Allah says, "Aqimis salata li dhikri," and mention "Aqimis salata li dhikri." Establish the prayer, said, with mentioning me, with my mention, with my remembrance. So when you are praying, you must keep talking about Allah, because it is the prayer is written. So the prayer in Surah Al-Fatiha, it's all about Allah. You better choose even some verses that are talking about the magnificence and the perfection of Allah. So that is when you are praying. When you are in the Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ أَفِيضُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسُ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. When you are done the Hajj, all those sections, then you go where people are going to. They keep talking about Allah, mention Allah, dhikrullah. So that is dhikrullah. When you are giving salah, you are mentioning dhikrullah. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said to us in the Quran, وَلَا تَنِيَا فِي ذِكْرِيَ ذْهَبَا إِلَىٰ فِرْحَوْرِ إِنَّهُ دَبَىٰ. That's in the case of Musa and Harun, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to them, do not undermine, do not neglect, do not forget my dhikr, mentioning me. And you go, and you go to Fir'aun, who was a transgressor and oppressor, and you will win. And because of that dhikrullah, you will win. I will complete the other part in the next section. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, I'm talking about dhikrullah. To remember Allah, to remind others about Allah, to mention about the perfection of Allah and how Allah is glorious. So that is the meaning of dhikrullah, and there are certain those terminologies which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us, and they are all in the Quran. And so we do it in our prayer and in our fasting and in our Hajj performances. And the salat, all of them
are based on different lives, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned all of them. So I said that when Allah sent Musa and Harun to Fir'aun, who was the emperor that was strong and powerful, and he sent to them, even though both of them, they were not even in the status of being first class citizens. So, and they were considered as slaves in that situation, and Allah sent them to make them convert to Islam. So what happened? They said to Allah, "Inna nakhafa an yadhgha alayna," or Allah, "Inna nakhafa an yafrud alayna aw an yadhgha." We are afraid that he may oppress us, go against us, and put us into prison or whatever. So when they said that, Allah says, "Idhaba ila Fir'aun inna udhaga." Before he said, Allah said that, he said, "Wala taniya fi dhikri idhaba ila Fir'aun inna udhaga." Do not forget mentioning me while you are on your way going to him, and when you are with him, and all the time. When you are mentioning me, then you will win. That's what they did, and they won. So let me relate that to like narrating one story, which has happened in the Muslim history. That story was, and there was this man named Zamakhshari. He's a well-known leading Muslim scholar who was a mystic. So that man, he lived somewhere around Afghanistan area, and so he said to them, people there, they used to hear in Eastern Europe, there were always chaos, fightings, corruption, killing, genocide, all kinds of, you mentioned, bad things were happening there. So this man, he said, as a Muslim leader, I should go there and I should deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Islam, which means peace. So I want to take peace and security message to those countries over there and give them. So the Islam is peace and security, not what we see nowadays, which is the opposite, completely opposite. Then, when he said that, his friends and relatives, they all gone against him. They said to him, "How come you are putting yourself into this risk? You are going to those countries where people are killing even their own people, and they are robbing and raping and looting, doing every kinds of bad things. And you are going there even though you are a foreigner and you may not understand their language, and you're just going there, you're just killing yourself very clearly." He said, "Don't worry, I will win. I will go there and I will simply call them to accept the Islam. So I'm giving them that invitation about Islam, and hopefully they will accept it. And that's what I'm doing." So they are, his Sahaba's group, or his students, refused to go with him. They said, "We cannot risk ourselves, I'm sorry." So only one man went with him. They went to those countries which were called Balkan countries. The Balkans are Kosovo, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Montenegro, and those countries, all to even Albania, those countries. He went to them, and he said, "I will only go with one weapon, that is Dhikrullah. I will keep saying the Dhikrullah, so my tongue will be always and pronouncing the Dhikrullah, and then they will accept me." He went to them with the Dhikrullah, keep mentioning Allah, and showing them how Islam is peace and security and tranquility. Then, after a few years, all of those countries converted to Islam. They became Muslim. And they are now, you see, they are Muslim majority up to now. That is what Sheikh Zamakhshari has done with the Dhikrullah. So this is exactly related to what Musa alayhi salam has done in the case of Fir'aun, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, "You go with my dhikri and you will win." So they went to him and they won. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. The ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ is stronger and bigger than everything else. And that's why when we are praying, we say Allahu Akbar. So Allahu Akbar is the key of dhikrullah. And whatever we have in our hands, in our minds, are minor and inferior to the Allahu Akbar. So Allahu Akbar is means the greatest is Allah. Therefore, dhikrullah has that significance. It is that thing which is really necessary, and it is as necessary as we need the food, and we need to keep having the dhikrullah in group. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and you go, مثل برادرز ثم تتفكروا, you go like one by one, or in a group or two group people. You go somewhere, sit down together and talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Musa alayhi salam, when he asked Allah to give him Harun as his assistant, he said to him, oh Allah, I want you to appoint Harun, my brother, as my assistant who will go with me to fulfill this mission. And what was the condition? He said, كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا. The main point is that we make a speech to you as a group. كَيْ نُسَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا. To talk about the perfection of Allah in a group. So what I'm saying in our conclusion is that dhikrullah is the one of the major things that we must be carrying it in every second in our life. So that dhikrullah, you can it's included the tasbih, the istighfar, the tahmid, the tahleel. That means you keep saying astaghfirullah, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Those are the words which should be in your mouth throughout your life. And even when you are eating or talking, you can say it in your heart, in mind only. That is what I advise myself first and then to yourself, that we keep mentioning the dhikrullah throughout our life and accepting that. It doesn't matter whether we count how many times we said, or we just say. The best way is that you don't need to count. You just keep saying it, and Allah is counting, because Allah will not neglect you. Any of our good deeds. إِبَادَ اللَّهِ يُوسِيكُمْ بِتَحْوَى اللَّهِ عَزَى وَجَلَّ وَحَذِّرُكُمْ بِنَفْسِي وَنَفْسِكُمْ بِمُخَالَفَةِ اللَّهِ وَعِسْيَانِكُمْ وَذَكِّرُكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ بَدَأَ اللَّهُ بِنَفْسِي ثُمَّ أَمَرَ بِمَلَائِكَتِي ثُمَّ أَمَرَنَا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. So just as the last reminder, I want you to distinguish between praising Allah and praising Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To praise Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to make the salat that was preached to us in this verse that I just finished it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also to make salat on us. Allah is saying, salli alayhim inna salawatuka sakanullahu. So he is making salat on us and we are making salat on him, but we are perfecting Allah. So the dhikr I'm talking about is exclusively to Allah Almighty. Wa aqimus salat.